Hello, happy morning to you all. I hope all of you are doing fine, staying at home and taking care of yourself during such time. I hope you are doing your best to see that your neighbors also are comfortable, and those who are around needing some help, you are rendering a good support for them and taking care of them also. And that is a good character of a citizen, that you should have it. And I also learned that some of you on different apps have already started to learn something which is in class 12. That's good of you. But at the same time, apart from learning from different apps that you are already on, you continue to learn from the instructions that we are going to pass from here at the school, and then prepare for your final exams. Our final goal is to come out with flying colors. And some of you staying at home, right, don't think that it is for full relaxation, and help your parents at home and do your best. Some who want to or who have to take up one or two re-exams to come to class 12, don't underestimate yourself and think that you will pass them colorfully or fairly. Prepare well during these exams, still time is there, and I have all the hope all 72 of you are going to be with me in next year. Next, you may ask me, sir, why are you with this cap, all this, right, in this classroom? Why? During this corona time, right, I thought to take care of myself and to sanitize very easily my head. What is that which I did is, I have a clean shave. Clear? And I hope most of you, right, if you show your photos to me, you will also look like this. And with this, what is that which I have done? That I have avoided to go to barber frequently now for some more days, and then becomes easy to sanitize and see any infection, if it is there, is easily washed off. That is the first reason. And in front of me, who are all there are? Riju, Anjali, Mahalakshmi, Srinivas, etc., etc. And those who are away, Samarth, Venkatesh, don't worry, you are, even if you are away, right now you are in front of me. And one more happy thing that I learned from Venkatesh is, before going for vacation, he had some health issues, and later in a message to me, he had said, he is fit and fine, I am happy about that. And Venkatesh, keep yourself fit, fine, and when you come back, I know you will continue to work hard and do well. Now, coming to what we should start from today. And as we know, first thing that we have to do is a bit of small shloka which we used to recite in class 10th, and when we came to class 11th, we forgot. No, some of you still remember. And afterwards, later, now again, time for us to repeat that, and then afterwards pray for our well-being and then best performance. Shall we do it once? Yes. Jnananandamayam devam nirmala spatikakrutim adharam sarvavidyanam hayagrivam upasmahe. Right? Keep repeating it whenever you start your study. That should help. This is the faith that we have. Clear? Okay. Next. What is the first question that I ask whenever I start any chapter in the classroom? Any wonder? No. So, first thing that I ask is, where are we? Where are we? Don't tell that I am in Chinese school, Bijapur, Karnataka, India. No, think in a larger perspective and answer to my question. And finally, the answer that I get from you all will be universe, right? So as we most of the time tell, think locally, act globally, right? So if you start coming up on those lines, you will prosper well, and then you will be a better citizen in life. So you said, yes, we are in universe. Now the next question is, when we say, sir, we are in universe, what is there in this universe? Next question. So in the universe, when we discuss about last year in thermodynamics, we understood that in universe there is a system and surroundings. We know what the system. System is that which is under study. Surroundings, all that which is around the system, that is the surroundings. And in the universe, system plus surroundings is universe. So what is there in the surroundings? In the surroundings, there is matter. What is matter again? First question that we answer. Matter is anything that has mass and occupies space. And now, this matter we again classify. And when we classify this matter, we start saying that it is pure substances, impure substances. And further when you go down, pure substances are those which have only one kind of atoms or one kind of molecules. And we know what we call those which are having only one type of atoms, we call them as elements. And all those which have only one type of molecules, we say compounds. Then what are impure substances? Impure substances are a mixture of two elements, two compounds, or two or more elements, two or more compounds, or elements and compounds in different proportions. That we say it is a mixture. And in the mixture, when we talk about later, we say there are two types of mixtures. What are these two types of mixtures? We say one homogeneous mixture, another one heterogeneous mixture. Now, what is homogeneous mixture? We know, right? This is not new for you. Homogeneous mixture is that where the components present are not seen even under microscope. We know two or more components are present, but we can't trace out, or these compounds can't be outlined even under microscope. That is homogeneous mixture. Other one, the heterogeneous mixture, where we can clearly outline the components that are present, and that we call it as heterogeneous mixture. I need not give an example. You know many. Just to recall, if I put small amount of salt or sugar in water, we know both are together. But we can't show where is salt or where are particles of water. But if I take small amount of water, put some sand, you can clearly see two components separately. So now it is just to recall a simple example, what is a heterogeneous mixture. And now one of you will certainly tell me that, sir, instead of calling homogeneous mixture, we have a different term for that. What is the different term for that? Yes, as some of you are about to tell me, it is nothing but solution. Why I am talking about the solution is, that is the first chapter for us for this year. Now don't tell me, sir, in the textbook, first chapter is solid state. If you open the book, first chapter is solid state. And for the reasons that this solid state is dealt in more detail in physics from last year, that chapter has been removed for us. So that should be one happy thing for you. So that means you will not read about solids both for physics also and chemistry also. Is it clear? Now, what is the solution? So when I say what is the solution, you will say solution is a homogeneous mixture of two or more components. What are these two components which are there? Then you will start telling, sir, if I have two components or more components, the way in which we say is those components which are in smaller amounts, they are solutes, and the one which is in the larger component or larger amount in the mixture, that we say the solvent. Otherwise, we define solute in a different way. Solute is that substance which dissolves in solvent, and solvent is that substance in which solute dissolves. And later, depending on the number of components that are present in a solution, we say if two components are present, it is a binary solution. If three components are present, ternary solution. If four components are present, quaternary solution. We will not talk about all of these. So we will be talking about only binary solutions. That means in binary solutions we will have only two components, one in small amount, one in larger amount. And now, how can this solution form? This solution can form in different ways. The solution in which we are going to have is, it can be a solid in liquid, a liquid in liquid, liquid in solid, like this different types are there. And later, if you further say, your solution itself is a solid, or it can be a liquid, or it can be a gas. For example, air, which is a mixture of many gases, is a solution, but it is in the gaseous state. If I put salt into water, your solution is in the liquid state. If I put small amount of copper in gold, I will have a solution in the solid state. And in this chapter, we are not going to deal with all this. We are going to deal with solutions which are in liquid state. And later, when we talk about what is this solution which we have in liquid state, we have a solute, we have a solvent. Now, if I simply say I have a solution, it doesn't convey much meaning. I should tell how much amount of solute is present in solution. That will be having some meaning in that, and that will make some sense for that. If I take a beaker of water, put a pinch of salt into it or a pinch of sugar into it, if I say I have a solution, if people ask, you have put sugar, how much of sugar is there in that? If you say, I don't know, it has no meaning. So when I say, I have a solution, I also should tell how much of solute is present in that solution. So for that, last year we have already come across many terms to tell how much of solute is present in the solution. And those terms, as we know, they are parts per million, percentage by mass, volume by percentage by volume, mass by volume, molarity, molality, normality, formality, mole fraction. These are the terms which you have already come across. And all these terms that we just said, we say they are concentration terms to talk about or to tell about amount of solute present in the solution. So when I say how much of, or which are those which are going to form solutions, which are those which are going to form solutions, that means the one which likes the other one, they will mix up. If they don't mix up, you will not have a solution. So that means like dissolves like. So to have a solution formed, the two substances or two or more substances which come together, they should like each other, then only a solution will form. That is, to repeat, like dissolves like. That is one thing. Next is about the solution. We know we have three types of solution this way, depending on how much of solute is present in the solution. One is unsaturated solution, next saturated solution, next supersaturated solution. What is unsaturated solution? Again, quickly recall, solution in which some more amount of solute can be made to dissolve, unsaturated solution. Saturated solution, no more solute can be made to dissolve, saturated solution. Supersaturated solution, more amount is made to dissolve, that is supersaturated solution. So when I say supersaturated solution, now you certainly tell, sir, supersaturated solution, we can have it at a higher temperature. So from this word that which you have to understand, that means temperature decides how much of substance or how much of solute is going to dissolve to give you a solution. And the same way, pressure also will decide how much of solute is going to dissolve in the given solvent or finally later in the solution. Okay, before we go ahead, I just want to recall what is all that which we did. First, we had a welcome, then afterwards we understood what is universe, and afterwards we understood what are the different types of solutions depending on number of components present, and then depending on the state of the solution, the three types of solutions. Later to tell how much is the solute present in the solution, we understood what are the different concentration terms, and afterwards what is the amount of solute that has dissolved. Based on that, we understood what are different types of solutions in a different way. Now, the question is, if a substance is given to me and if I want to find out whether it is a pure substance or impure substance, how to find whether it is a pure substance or impure substance, it is not new for us. We know pure substances have physical constants. When I say physical constants, means they will not change. What are those physical constants? Melting point, boiling point, if it is a liquid, vapor pressure, density, viscosity, surface tension. Of course, all this at a given temperature and pressure, when we want to determine one of them, they remain constant. So for a given substance, if these are observed wherever you are constantly, then we say they are pure substances. If a substance that is given to me, at one time it will show one boiling point, the same substance that I have, after some time it will have a different physical constant. That is, depending on the amounts of substances that are present, there will be variation in that. That means, if boiling point doesn't remain constant for a given substance with me, then I say it is impure substance. So that means boiling points are not constant, freezing points are not constant, vapor pressure not constant. So when we observe all this, then we say I have an impure substance. An impure substance, again, which is homogeneous mixture, then I say impure substances which are homogeneous, not having physical constants, it is a solution. A substance that is given to me having all these physical constants always, that means it could be an element or it could be a compound. And as we are discussing about solution, we will not worry about elements and compounds. Right? At length we have studied about elements and compounds. We have to know something about solutions bit more, which will later help to understand the properties of substances in different ways. Now, to decide whether the property which I am deciding for a given substance, whether it is the same or not, that I should know what is the vapor pressure. I should know what is boiling point. I should know what is freezing point. I should know about viscosity. I should know about surface tension. Some of them, right, we have already studied last year in the chapter states of matter. In states of matter, right, we have come across all these properties for gases separately, liquid separately, but there we did not discuss about these properties for solutions. And if I go for the properties of these solutions, we will find a difference, and that difference that we find for these solutions will help us to learn something more. So now each one of us are curious to know how these properties that vary for solutions will help us. You have to wait, and to learn more about that, you have to wait for this continuation of this lesson for tomorrow. Take care. If you want to do some revision of this, you are at will. Whatever that you did not understand, right, go back to 11th standard textbook and more about that molarity, all that, and practice some problems. Meanwhile, right, I will be sending some questions based on whatever that we have studied last year. Let us not waste time. Time is short, but we have to go a long way. So I don't want to repeat everything in the classroom, right? I will send some questions in the group for whatever that is going to help for this chapter. You solve them and send your answers to me. We'll go ahead. Bye.